Welcome everyone. Thanks a lot for staying with us. You're watching Plain Speak with me, Shivani Gupta, and we're joining you live from the CNN News 18 and Federal Bank Primetime Studio. A horrific incident from Bengal has sparked massive outrage and anger. A video from Chopra in Uttar Dinajpur district in West Bengal shows a man brutally thrashing a couple with a bamboo stick made broom. The woman being dragged by her hair, thrashed and beaten in front of several people, mostly men who are just standing around. This after an order, apparently, passed by what are generally referred to as kangaroo courts. After massive outrage, a case has been registered and the man in question, Tajmul Haq, alias JCB, has been arrested. The BJP claims that the accused is a close associate of the ruling TMC and known for such acts in the area. Basically, he is accused to be an executioner of Sharia court verdicts. Trinamool Congress MLA of the area, Hamidul Rahman, went on to blame and shame the female victim, justifying this mob justice for the couple. The MLA also made a Freudian slip, according to some. He said this is a village matter and is acted upon according to Muslim Rasht, rules of a Muslim Rasht. This comment of his was picked up by the BJP to point out to rule of a Muslim mob or Sharia law in Bengal under the patronage of Mamata Banerjee. Now, the MLA since has refuted he used the word Rashtra, but said that he only said that this justice was according to Muslim caste. Be that as it may, it is still illegal and absolutely abhorrent. The issue with this case is the twin hypocrisy of the opposition, which claims to stand for all individuals, the constitution, secularism, justice and democracy, which for some reason doesn't speak up enough on Bengal at all and is choosing to ignore an inflammatory comment by the local MLA on religion only because it is inconvenient to their politics. Religious hegemony is rarely ever challenged by them when it is not coming from Hindu quarters. That's the big question we ask today. Is this emboldenment of such elements in Bengal and silence on the matter only due to appeasement politics? We'll take that question to our guests in just a bit. First up, the woman was thrashed on the streets in Bengal in broad daylight, yet comment after comment seemed to justify this heinous act and the reasoning behind it as well. So this is the local MLA. Defense number one by Hamidul Rahman was that this woman left her husband and indulged in unsocial acts, so it's okay to do what that man is doing in that horrific video. And of course, it is even more horrifying the fact that the mob is just standing around and this seems to be par for the course for them. There are some rules and laws in Muslim caste is also what the MLA went on to say to justify that, you know, this is just how it goes. Of course, the BJP claims that he didn't say Muslim caste. He said Muslim Rasht. The MLA concerned is denying that, although we do have the statement on record. Now, the Trinamool Congress government also seems to make what seemed to be a defense of what has transpired, which is to say that there are many such instances that also take place in BJP-ruled states, so there should be no politicization of it. But remember, this is not politicization if an issue is raised. And the opposition, including the TMC, can hardly claim that they don't politicize such events in other states. The spotlight is on these two gentlemen, Tajmul Haq and Hamidul Rahman. So who are these men in question and why is it that the BJP is using their name to attack the state government and is accusing them of shielding them? So Tajmul Haq is the man who's seen in the video dispensing that mob justice against that couple. He's known by the name alias. He doesn't really hold any position in the TMC but is known as a strongman in the Chopra area. Tajmul is accused of intimidating voters in the area during panchayat elections gone by as well. In fact, locals allege that this is not the first time that he has done something like this or he's been involved or called for kangaroo justice. He's done so in the past as well. On the other hand, Hamidul Rahman is the two-term Trinamool Congress MLA from the area. He is very much associated with the TMC and seemingly justified what took place. Only solace in his statement was he felt it was slightly over. Maybe they went overboard in handing out that so-called justice. They could have reined themselves a little bit, but he justified both the justice and the reasoning behind it. He has come from the Congress party in 2011. This is, of course, roughly when the powers in Bengal changed hands, and since then has been with the TMC in 2012. In April this year, the Election Commission of India issued him a show cause notice for allegedly intimidating voters. The TMC MLA is reportedly involved in post-poll violence incidents as well. So these are just the sketches of the characters involved as far as this case is concerned. Now, Bengal's law and order situation has been under question for quite some time. It's not really a matter alone about who's in power now. This has happened in the past when the left was in power too. But the question that arises today is this: why is today's opposition, which is in this India bloc, quiet over what happens in West Bengal? Why is West Bengal a blind spot for today's opposition? Let me just point out a few recent cases that have happened. Imagine if any of them had happened in any BJP ruled state, what the reaction of the combined opposition would have been. Just a few days ago, in fact last week, the BJP has accused the TMC of beating up a female member of their minority Morcha. The woman concerned was allegedly beaten up and paraded naked. They have even asked for a CBI inquiry as far as this case is concerned. The TMC is not denying the incident, but is saying that it happened because of family dispute. That's again hardly a letter to write about the law and order situation. Now in June again, Indian Secular Front worker's wife was allegedly assaulted by TMC workers. Yet we don't hear a lot of outrage about it from the opposition in Bengal also. The infamous Sandesh Khali episode in February earlier this year, women of Sandesh Khali coming out on the streets, taking on, in fact, the police and others against TMC strongman Sheikh Shahjahan, who was defended and shielded for weeks against allegations of sexual assault and land grab. In July last year, a woman was reportedly thrashed and sexually assaulted in Murshidabad, allegedly by TMC goons, just because she joined the Congress party. When two Congress workers tried to save the victim in that case, they were also beaten up by the miscreants. So basically, as some may have accepted, not just the BJP, some Congress leaders, some left leaders may also have accepted, it is a sin to be part of the opposition today in West Bengal under Mamata Banerjee. Now in May 2022, I want to remind you, two BJP workers were allegedly converted forcefully from Hinduism to Islam. The Calcutta High Court, in fact, ordered a Central Bureau of Investigation and National Investigation Authority investigation into the matter, into the issue of forced conversions in Malda district. So this is what goes on, but somehow it isn't kosher to talk about West Bengal, not just for the media, but also for the opposition today. The question we ask is simply this: with this Sharia Court in action that has come to light, is it not appeasement of a particular section that is to blame, and also for the silence when such incidents come to light from some parts of India?
চরিত্রবান হয়েছে, এখন তো একটা আমাদের মুসলিম কাস্টের সামাজিক আচার বিচার হয়ে থাকে।
The entire country is shocked after seeing the brutal video of a Talibani style kangaroo court justice. What is unfortunate is that those who speak up about Manipur, about women's issues, today they are eloquently silent.
And in the BJP rule states in the other part of the countries, we often see such type of incidences.
Let's go across to our guest joining us, Shazia Ilmi, national spokesperson of the BJP with us. Atiqur Rahman is an Islamic scholar. Pratim Ranjan Bose is a columnist and journalist based in West Bengal. We're also awaiting Tausif Khan, a lawyer and TMC supporter, for joining us. But Shazia, let me begin with you. You must have seen the response that has come in from the TMC. They're saying don't politicize this incident. Don't use it for political mileage. It's not as if these incidents don't come to light from BJP ruled states. Your response on that first.
I'm extremely shocked at what I've seen. These are horrific visuals and they make me feel really sad. And the part that really gets me is that we choose our reactions according to the state where such atrocities are happening. And when women are being treated so badly and being beaten up in public, in broad daylight, and we choose a response based on politics. It's a matter of great shame that a woman was treated so badly in a state which has a woman chief minister, and nobody seems to say a word on it. Rahul Gandhi spoke on so many issues in this typical comical manner of his, but refused to utter a word for this woman who was beaten up by Tajmul Haq, or whatever his name is. And you have just shown us and given us an account of all that has happened. It is so sad. After the Vidhan Sabha elections too, there were senior citizens, some women who were raped in front of the grandchildren. There was a young Dalit girl who was gang raped. You know why? Because they had to be politically shamed. And here you just see if there is some kind of mentality. And these pictures, where do you see them? I can't believe you're seeing them in independent India. The clothes, the attire gives it away. But you see them in Iran, where women are being beaten up and they have been killed because of protesting. And in Afghanistan, when Taliban, warriors and police and administration are beating women mercilessly. But this is happening in West Bengal, in our country. And we all are quiet. You know why? Why we are quiet? Because no, this is not BJP run, this is TMC run. And because we have to protect TMC, we have to protect the Indy alliance. And so we'll be quiet. A woman can be ill-treated.
But it doesn't matter. So is it that women in non-BJP ruled states don't matter? I'll come to that question, but Tausif is joining us.
They don't deserve any dignity. They don't deserve any respect. You know why? Because they're in non-BJP states. So they can be beaten and raped.
And we can turn a blind eye. And there are too many such incidents that are happening, and particularly in West Bengal. But I want to go across to Tausif, who's joining us as well. Tausif, you know, what is even more shocking, apart from the fact that this has happened, and I am not going to deny that something like this could have happened in any other state in India too, but what is shocking is that these are local strongmen who are linked to the ruling party. When such cases come to light, there is national outrage politically. Secondly, the local MLA has come on record to justify the act. He's saying this is how it goes. This is a matter that is decided at the local level like this. And yet there is no action from the party against the MLA.
There is more to the media. You see, both the couple were beaten up, who are accused of adultery. Even though under CRPC, adultery is no crime after 2018 judgment, the women can never be touched. And this sort of action, public flogging or mob justice, is not culture of Bengal. And therefore, the person seen beating up the couple, both the man and the woman who he was beating with the bamboo stick, as it was seen on the video, he was arrested yesterday itself. He is behind bars. Because Mamata Banerjee has zero tolerance for this.
But how does this man have the bravado? Tausif, unfortunately, I'm having very poor, patchy network with you, so your audio is coming and going. But how does this man have the bravado to do this in today's day and age where everything gets shot on a mobile phone? That points to political bravado. That points to the fact that his local MLA is protecting him. And I reiterate, the local MLA did justify his action.
See, regardless of what local MLA is saying, the party is not even protecting the local MLA.
But you've not acted against him.
Against the MLA.
No, but the party has not acted against the local MLA.
You see, the offense here is involved the one who is involved in the offense has been taken into custody, and it is the person, whoever his name is, the man in the
Tajimul
black
Haq.
T-shirt, who was, yes, Tajimul Haq, who was seen beating both the man and the woman. So you see in the media they are saying a woman is being beaten up. No, it's a couple who has been, regardless of who is beating.
Yeah, he said, no, but can I just tell you, yes, the man also got a little bit, but this man, Tajimul Haq, in the video that at least we have, reserved most of his beating for the woman. You know, he at one point lifted her hand and deliberately hit her on her breast. That's the kind of man we're talking about.
I'm not going into the debate of what is the duration of the video that you have.
Yeah, but we know what mindset that man carries.
Yes. And that mindset is not acceptable at all. A couple may be in adulterous relationship under the Indian law, under the CRPC and IPC, after 2018 judgment, no one can take law in their own hand. Just by accusing someone of adulterous relationship, you cannot go and beat him. And that is why he is behind bars.
Okay, Shazia wants to come in. Shazia, one by one, go ahead. What's your objection?
Shivani, I have a strong objection to the line of defense that is being taken up by Kaushik, by him constantly referring.
One by one, Shazia.
What defense? It's a fact.
How does
it's
it matter?
Fact.
Why are you bringing
yeah,
it up?
Yeah, it does not matter. That's what I'm saying. It does not matter.
Adultery. It was a couple. It was not just a woman. Why are you doing this, Kaushik? I'm beginning to suspect
because
your mindset.
You tell half
and
truth.
The misogyny you're displaying
you
right
lie
now.
On TV. Shazia, if you had not lied on TV, if you had not spoken half truth,
why do you think
my task would have been easier?
I mean, this is bad enough to see anybody being hit, but
no.
to have a woman who's being hit regularly, and not just that,
a couple
she's being
in adulterous relationship.
She tries to get up.
I am absolutely with you.
Why
I am absolutely with you. I am absolutely with you, Shazia. I am saying that no one has a right to beat up a woman who is in an adulterous relationship. Even the law never permitted it. Even 2018.
But the fact is, I think what Shazia is pointing out to, one second,
Tasif,
I think what Shazia is pointing out to the fact is that, you know, declaring that you are in an adulterous relationship and condemning you because somehow we all now believe that they were in an adulterous relationship in itself is a problem. You cannot have 10 men of such mentality get together and decide, oh, we have caught you in an adulterous relationship, so we are going to teach you a lesson. So whatever
absolutely.
The reasons or the motivations of this man may be are irrelevant. And again
it
and again saying that it is not a crime under IPC is irrelevant. Is the point
absolutely.
That I think we are trying to make. My question to you stands. Tasif, my question to you stands before I go to our other guest. Why is it that the party, despite an on-record statement defending this by the local MLA, does not have the gumption to even show cause him, does not have the gumption to even suspend him pending an inquiry? What action have you taken?
Shivani, first of all, please let me clarify. I am not defending this person.
I get that. I get that.
Neither the state government nor the Trinamool party. And it is for this reason that regardless of what the people there were aware of, whether the woman was in an adulterous relationship or not, whether after 2018 adulteration
is irrelevant.
Even when it was, it is irrelevant. That's why he's arrested. That's what
then
I'm saying.
Why are you mentioning it?
That, but BJP will never do. Did you see this BJP spokesperson saying when the man in Gujarat was killed? Did the BJP spokesperson raise hue and cry why the man was mob lynched in Gujarat, why men are being mob lynched in Uttar Pradesh? They are the hypocrites of the highest. They are the hypocrites.
Okay,
they will never
on hypocrisy,
any word, a single word when a mob lynching.
But you didn't answer my question. Now I don't want to get into whataboutry, but you didn't answer my question of why the party in power in Bengal is refusing to act against its own MLA. Arresting this man may have become a compulsion for the party now, given that this video went viral and obviously nobody in their right mind cannot act. But the MLA is on record to justify it. On the issue of hypocrisy, Shazia, very quickly before I go to our other guest, BJP says that you don't talk about this when it's in Bengal, or when Sharia courts of this kind come to light, the opposition goes mum.
Well, absolutely. And you know, all the leaders who talk about women's rights and how misogynistic BJP is and what they do. And I'm not saying don't talk about Brijbhushan. Please do. And do talk about Hathras as much as you want. But why would he be quiet by the same standards on something as terrible and horrific as this?
Yeah.
So you choose. You choose according to the state where this is happening. You choose according to the religion of the perpetrator and of the victim. You choose selectively, which is exactly what you did in Sandesh Kali, which is exactly what you continue to do in West Bengal, where you women are gang-raped and beaten up, and men are set fire to only because they have voted not for TMC, but for BJP.
Yeah, and
so let's just be honest.
Interestingly, interestingly, this happens to all opposition parties in Bengal, but somehow, due to, I think, national politics compulsion, they don't speak out, or their national leaders don't speak out. Often I have debated this, and the defense I get, Pratim Ranjan Bose, is that, oh, our local leaders have raised it, oh, our local leaders have, you know, talked, said this, said that. But why don't their national faces talk about cases like this? Is it not purely because it's inconvenient, both politically because of the state that it's happening in, and socially because of the individuals involved in this case?
Perfectly. You see, West Bengal is the biggest victim of national political equations. During, see, this lynching, if you just go back and check records, lynching has been very common in West Bengal at one point of time, during the left regime. And every argument finally comes to justification of West Bengal somehow or the other. You see, let's just be very free and fair. Let's look at Gujarat, look at UP. Things, whatever happens, be it lynching, whatever, I'm not justifying anything. Everything goes up to London, New York or wherever. It's carried in Washington Post and everywhere. What about West Bengal? And it has been happening for years. Now, coming down to this particular case, you see, are we singling out one couple is being beaten by a Sharia court or a kangaroo court? It is not. You just look at it. In 1 week, there are at least 4 deaths in lynching. And this time, please remember, earlier this lynching used to take place in far-flung districts. Now it is happening in and around Calcutta. 2 died in Calcutta and rest 2 are in Greater Calcutta. So this indicates that there is a design. There is a design of lawlessness. And it is happening. And why it is happening? Simple reason, as we saw in the case of Sandesh Kali, Shah Jahan Sheikh, the chief minister, went on supporting Shah Jahan Sheikh from the floor of assembly. There was no gumption. There was no nothing. A straight frontal support. Similarly, if you want to stop this, she can stop this in a day, I tell you. Habibur Rahman had the guts to say this on camera in today's world, that it is as it is justified by Sharia. He said Muslim Rashtra. So whatever it is, he should have immediately been, you know, there should have been immediately a case.
So you're saying that there is, of course, truth when the opposition, in this case, it may come from the BJP particularly, but when the opposition in Bengal says that, see, this is all because of appeasement.
Well, I mean, see, Rahul,
that is why such elements are so emboldened. I'm saying it plainly because the show is plain speak. There are Muslim strongmen and a minority vote bank considerations, and that is why some of those elements, which are criminal elements, are running amok. Some people even say that even Mamata Banerjee is no longer in control of them.
Of course. You see, it is not that Muslims are spared. If you remember, 4-5 years ago, there was a case of lynching in Kuchbihar, and all 4 were Muslims. Similarly, in Murshidabad, if I recall correctly, 2 Muslims died due to lynching. So it is not that, you know, anyone is spared, but it is a case of complete crumbling of this
law and order
situation. And look at the funny side of the story. Rahul Gandhi has been speaking against, you know, the atrocities on minorities. No, can't he speak for or against this lawlessness,
which affects minorities in West Bengal as well?
Everyone. I mean, why are we including, you know, why are we looking at law through the prism of, from the community or caste?
Or religion. But you know, we have to be honest about the kind of polity we have, right? We've always looked at crime, particularly in the last few decades, from the prism of religion. And that's exactly fundamentally the problem and the question that goes back to opposition today, because they somehow go very quiet when there are incidents where individuals of the minority community are the perpetrators. Like in this case, even if the victims are Muslims, they somehow get sidelined. If the perpetrators are from the minority community, that's the pattern we have seen. Atiqur Rahman, imagine the outrage if there was a BJP MLA who on camera says that, you know, so such and such act has happened, this is justified in Hindu Rashtra. Now, this is exactly what the local TMC MLA has said, that this is okay because this is according to Muslim Rashtra. That is what at least people say, everybody heard him saying, he's saying he didn't say Rashtra, he said it caste, but irrelevant. Even if I say he's saying justifying it as, you know, some sort of internal societal justice of Muslim caste. Imagine the outrage if the tables were turned, if this was a BJP ruled states, MLA is BJP and is talking of Hindu Rashtra and of dispensing such mob justice. Does the opposition not stand exposed on their hypocrisy today?
Shivani, I refuse to enter into the political domain as far as this particular incident is concerned. But I would like to draw your attention to something very intriguing in this particular episode. That is, that as far as Islam and Quran goes, it is a very, very strict punishment for those men who try to accuse the woman of any such adulterous relationship. There are witnesses called. Shivani, can you hear me?
Sir, I can hear you, but I am sorry. I will intervene only because I am not interested in getting into a theological debate of whether this is justified under Muslim law or not. That's not my argument. That's not my aim. My question was very clear. Forget religion and what it preaches or teaches. I am not an expert. Not many of us here are experts. It's an irrelevant debate. You talk to three different scholars, they'll tell you three different things. So I'm not willing to get into that debate. My question is simple. In a nation where day after day after day, you are told your minorities are in danger, it is a problem when the opposition does not rise up and speak against criminal elements that come from the minority community and political elements who then go on to defend such cruelty in the name of religion. That is my question.
So Shivani, since I am as a researcher on Islamic studies, I can only tell you that what forbids in Islam and what does not.
You comment on Indian politics. Come on, Atiqur Rahman, you comment on Indian politics all the time.
Yes.
Don't cop out now.
I am not negating. If you want me to speak on the minority's point of view, then I shall come in.
Yes, so do you not find it a problem that there's a sitting MLA of a party who's saying that this is okay as per Muslim rules and there's no problem in a secular democratic India? The opposition hasn't spoken a word?
That's what I want to pinpoint as far as the Indian laws are concerned. Indian courts are there. We do not have any space for any Sharia courts. Be they them or majority, minority communities, a ghettoization. Now here comes the question that why the Indian minorities, basically the Muslims, are in such situation wherein all the time they are in the dots whenever tug of war between two political parties are there. We need to question all political parties.
Yes, so question all political parties. That's exactly my point. Why is the TMC not getting questioned here? Why are you beating around the bush? Why are you going around in circles?
Tausif Bhai has immediately accepted that this is the one case wherein this culprit should be punished to the utmost this thing.
What about the MLA? Why is everybody nicely, swiftly sidestepping the MLA's question?
I think you are trying to get me in such a situation that I should tell you that we support such things.
No, I'm asking you maybe to condemn the MLA, but you are unwilling to do so.
No. Since I was asked about the Sharia courts, and I am sitting as a lecture on Islamic studies.
No, I didn't ask you about Sharia courts at all, Atiqur Rahman. You come on my show multiple times and you have never shied away from commenting about you have never shied away from commenting on Indian polity and politics. You have never shied away from saying that, see, Muslims in India feel endangered. You have never shied away from saying that there is a politics of hate against Muslims in India. My question to you is simple. No, you're coming out. No, Islamic studies, you are talking about every 2 seconds today.
I'm a lecturer in political science. I will tell you what deep, this thing our politics has gone into. We should be ashamed of ourselves that we have politicians who support such crimes, whether it is the our wrestlers asking for justice or this particular woman asking for justice. What the BJP, the TMC, corporal parties are deep into it. This is the reality of Indian politics.
Okay, but my question to you was only, where is the outrage? No outrage?
Outrage will be there.
From opposition, will you plead to Rahul Gandhi that he should raise this case? Will you plead to Priyanka Gandhi that you should raise this case? That's the question.
I will support you. I will support you.
But you will not say it.
Today
you're seeming very, very, you're seeming like you're caught in some sort of a...
The wrestlers have not got justice.
The wrestlers issue I have discussed. I will not, no. I will not allow that. Wrestlers issue has been discussed. Atiqur Rahman, if you want to speak openly on the wrestlers issue, I have the right to question, why are you not speaking openly about this issue?
No, I am trying to tell you what is the gist of the problem, and you are refusing to listen to me.
Gist of the problem is what? That somehow Indian politicians are doing this when it comes to religion. I got that gist. Shazia, 30 seconds.
Atiq Saab just said, and I would like to say with all deference, what did he say just now? He says there are very strong laws in Islam about men who accuse women. And then he says what Tawseef Bhai is saying is great. I mean, Tawseef is the one who's talking about adultery and saying that there are different laws. Why should we even go to that space? And Atiq Saab, what is the harm in saying that this is a huge disservice to not just our Hindu brothers and sisters, but also to Muslims, to be seen in this manner and to associate with this? Our law is very clear. This has been how we are. Our contract is with the Constitution. All those who talk about Samvidhan, should go by the spirit of Samvidhan, even on these matters. Okay. Where does the Sharia come in? Or where does the Muslim mentality come in? Or where does the whole idea of adultery or no adultery come in?
The problem only is that a sitting MLA has said it, but somehow the entire opposition is turning a blind eye. Should I not question that? Of course I should question that. Pratim Ranjan Bose, 30 seconds. You wanted to come in.
If a sitting MLA in UP, Gujarat or any BJP ruled state has said something, half of it, it would have been an international news. And Rahul Gandhi would have come vehemently about it. I live in West Bengal and I am against this violence. I will support anyone who will look violence as violence and will act against it. Period.
Absolutely. I stand with that. Tawseef, onus on the TMC to walk the talk. It's not enough to, say this happens in other states too. Fair enough, it does. But your MLA has been on camera to justify this. Surely the TMC can act, show some action against him.
Well, you see, it's a party matter, if you think any disciplinary action should show cause to this MLA and on what grounds. It is purely their prerogative. But what we have seen on the public platform is that the man who was involved in the violence has been called out, has the West Bengal police suo moto lodged an FIR and arrested him. Investigation is on. And if there are required more people to be arrested, police will do that.
If so, that is a sufficient response, then that template should be followed for all such cases, is what I'm saying. Otherwise, the questions of hypocrisy will rise. And the questions of, nicely sifting through crimes, depending on what is a crime that we can raise, what is a crime we should just turn a blind eye on, those questions will arise on all parties. Even, let's say, in situations where the BJP is in opposition or the BJP is in power in some states. I do thank our guests for joining us.